Lee, and the 5 a.m. advisory just dropped, so we still have 80-mile-an-hour winds at its core. It slowed down by only 1 mile per hour, moving west-northwest at 13 miles an hour. Quickly still is expected to become a Category 2 later this afternoon, and then by tomorrow morning early, a Category 3 or major hurricane. Then it quickly, rapidly intensifies into a Category 4, a major and significant hurricane with 150-mile-plus mile-an-hour winds. It could, in fact, even become a 5. Very hot waters over here as it traverses well to the north and east of Puerto Rico, thankfully. Then it's going to take a right-hand swing and go up near Bermuda, according to the modeling. And here's why. We've got a high pressure north of it. We've got this trough, which is going to be significantly because it's digging south. And because of that upper-level motion, you see the counterclockwise spin of the hurricane. Well, it gets caught up in this channel. Thankfully, it keeps it away from the Florida Peninsula, but it could affect the U.S. Eastern Sea board with some high seas. It's caught in the sweet spot between high pressure and that trough. Thankfully, the timing is just perfect for that. So tracking the tropics again, we have another wave. This one just exited Africa. It's near the Cabo Verde Islands. It looks like it's going to develop into maybe Margo, which is the next storm. 60% and 80% chance. It too is moving west-northwest, but is a little bit further north than Lee. So hopefully no problem. We'll continue to look at it carefully.